Hello and welcome to my channel. Please like, share, and subscribe if you like this video. And thank you all so much for watching. Thank you, thank you, thank you to my day ones, twos, and threes. Thank you to all my new subscribers that's coming in. That means well. Thank you so very much. I appreciate you all and welcome, welcome, welcome. This video is for entertainment and educational purposes only, so everything is alleged, some is not, and the fair accuse is in my description box, y'all. So let's get to it, y'all. Let's get to it. So I've been reporting on what's been going on in Aurora, Colorado, about, you know, the Venezuelans coming and taking over apartment buildings and stuff like that. So I've been reporting on that. I've been reporting on everything that I'm hearing and, you know, just coming across my desk and all of that stuff. Okay, y'all. Well, word on the street is this is happening in Dallas, Texas now, y'all. And a lot of people in Dallas, Texas is saying, F around and find out. F around and find out if you want to. Okay, this is what they're saying. Everybody's allowed to carry there. So they're saying, if this is what you want, this is what you're going to get. Okay, y'all. Word on the street is the Venezuelans has taken over another apartment building, y'all. And they are saying that they are wreaking havoc on the people that were staying there. They're saying that, you know, they are calling the polices and this and that and this, and they're letting them do whatever it is that they want to do. They took over this apartment complex in Dallas, Texas. They are saying that they're breaking in people's cars, they're breaking in people's homes and all kind of stuff. And the police and everybody is just letting them do what they want to do. Okay, y'all, this is what they're saying. Now, this is the apartment complex that they said that they didn't took over. And they said that they are outside morning to night to night to morning. You can't tell if it's 2, 3 in the morning because they say that they stay outside sipping, smoking their kneecaps off, just rowdy, loud, acting a fool, and everything else. And when people that's in that area is putting in complaints, they're saying that nobody's coming. Nobody's coming to help nobody. Okay, y'all? I told y'all. I said this a couple videos back. I said if they let them get away with that in Colorado, this is going to happen everywhere. And now it is happening in Dallas, Texas, y'all. This is what they're saying. Now, this is what I'm hearing. I don't live there. I don't know. This is what is coming across my desk. And I'm just reporting it. Okay, y'all. They saying the Versailles, I guess that's how you say it, apartments complex is being taken over by the Venezuelans, y'all. And they're saying that they so rowdy and just loud and just, they saying that they are getting into paw sessions in the middle of the street with knives, y'all. This is what they're doing. And they're saying nobody's coming. People is scared that lives in the building that's still there so far. They're scared out their mind. And they don't have anywhere to go at this time. So they have to put up with what is going on right now. But word on the street is the police and everybody is letting them do whatever it is that they want to do at this particular moment. And I'm going to just say this, y'all. The streets is talking. And word on the street is street associates is starting to work together because they're not getting any help from authorities in the government right now, y'all. Word on the street. And I'm going to tell y'all this. A lot of street associates is now saying that they are going to vote for Trump, y'all. Lord have mercy. I never thought I'd see the day. I never thought I'd see the day. Okay, I just went from reading in my comment section them talking about Mexicans, how they're not taking no mess off of these Venezuelans, y'all. Okay? And how that the Mexicans and everybody is talking about they are sick of these Venezuelans and different migrants that's coming up here. The Mexican is handling, allegedly, you know, taking care of their business. I'm just saying, y'all, this is word on street. And they not taking no mess. And now, the street associates, y'all, that is normally into it with each other, is talking about, you know, combining themselves with others so that they can handle problems that's going on right now. Y'all, I told y'all this was going to get dangerous, didn't I? Didn't I tell you? But you can't do this everywhere. You cannot go to Dallas. You cannot go to different places and do this and think that there is not going to be some type of altercation or something that's going to take place, y'all. This is getting out of hand on so many levels, and I wish that the government would take the lead in this mess, because this could possibly cause a lot of people's lives, y'all. This could. This is getting ridiculous. Now, right on the street, they were saying that the Hells Angels was on their way to Colorado. I haven't heard anything else about it, y'all. But people are still reporting it. As you can see, I pulled this up. As you can see, they're saying that they're on their way to Colorado. Now, I don't know how long it's going to take them to get there, because people have been saying this for a few days now. But the thing of it is if this is who's going to have to deal with these Venezuelans, then they got their hands full, y'all. Because now they're popping up at different places, and allegedly, they're taking over more and more and more apartment buildings, y'all. And they're saying that this is a low-income apartment building that they then took over. So the people is not really caring, because there's minorities in there. So they don't care. And if they do take over the building, 9 times out of 10, after they didn't move everybody out and they didn't move in, everybody then left because of the crime going up and all of that other stuff that's going on right now, they'll probably, the landlord will probably get, you know, rewarded for the Venezuelans taking over the building. They'll probably be, you know, helping them pay their rent. Y'all, this is crazy, y'all. This is crazy on so many levels. I never thought I'd see today. And then I just seen a video of Kamala. I'm trying to remember where they say she was at today. Wherever it is that she was at recently, that she just did, you know, a rally or whatever you want to call it. It's starting to look bad for y'all. I'm going to just throw that out there. It's starting to look bad for Kamala right now. Because Kamala, where she just showed up at, the majority of the people that showed up wasn't supporting her. They were outside with their picket signs. And the people that came, that got in, that was in the inside, it was a handful, y'all. All the seats was empty. So different cities and states now that Kamala is showing up to, they showing her just how much they feel about her, y'all. And the situation that, you know, they have gotten us in. It's a shame, y'all, that all of this was for votes. You mean you could sit at a table and have a meeting like, oh, how can we beat Trump? How can we beat the Republicans? Oh, we can bring a whole bunch of people over here, get them citizenship, and then they'll vote for us, and then we can swing the vote in our favor. But the thing of it is, y'all, a lot of people that's coming over here now, some people that are helping, some people they're not. And word on the street, they are not helping some people on purpose so that they can be chaotic and be out here doing these type of crimes, because they are being left into the street and turned away. And they know these, some of these people got records, so they know they're going to, you know, go and start doing crimes in order to survive. Some of these people are saying that they not for Biden either, y'all, and Kamala, that they are bringing over here. Some of these people are saying the same thing. They're complaining about standing in lines for days and all of this stuff. And then the next day, you're doing the same thing over again. Some of these people are complaining and saying that they wish they could just go on back home, because it's not all as cracked up to be over here. I don't know how they're saying that when they're giving them everything but the kitchen sink. But this is what's going on right now. Is this going to backfire, y'all? Is this what is going to make Kamala and them lose the election? Ask yourself this question, because I'm telling y'all right now, there are so many people outside right now that's running around here, walking up to people, asking them who you want to vote for, who you this and that, that, that. And these people, the majority of the people, are saying Trump, y'all. And remember when I told y'all to be careful about these polls and stuff that they are putting up? Be careful in listening to these polls. Because remember, I forgot what election it was. I think it could have been Hillary or something like that. It could have been Hillary. But I'm not 100% sure. But they were saying that one was, you know, polling over the other. And then when it came down to it, it was all a lie to throw people off and make people comfortable to not go out and vote because they thought that they had it in a bag or whatever, whatever, whatever. And it was just a lost cause. It ended up being the other person that actually won. I talked about this a while ago. Everybody is saying, oh, she's leading in the polls. She's this, she's that, she's that. Y'all. And I want y'all to pay attention to one person that just dropped out of the election. And he backed Trump as well. Okay? He is backing Trump. And a lot of people feel like all his votes that people were going to vote for him is going to go to Trump. But they haven't tallied those in yet. Okay, y'all? They're still saying that she's, you know, ahead. Don't believe everything y'all hear, y'all, because I'm telling y'all, just because they set up that whole thing in Chicago and had all of those people there and this and that and that and this, mind y'all, it was like a concert, okay? People were mainly going so they can, you know, see these celebrities and this and that and that and this. It wasn't even about really just, you know, everybody's just going to vote for her, okay, y'all? And some serious stuff are brewing, and I do believe that it's backfiring on Biden and them right now, as it should, because I'm going to just put this out there. We wouldn't be in a situation that we're in right now with these, you know, hostile takeovers and stuff of buildings and all of this stuff if they would have did things the way they were supposed to do them in the first place. If you're going to let people come into the country, you do the paperwork. They go through the proper, you know, procedures like everybody else to get over here. They didn't do that. So it's a possibility now that this is going to backfire, y'all. But anyway, prayers up for the people in Dallas at this building complex that's going through it, y'all. Y'all know I got a soft spot for Dallas, okay? Dallas has made me who I am today as far as, you know, on YouTube, period, okay? So I have to give my shout out to Dallas on everything. And are a lot of people worried about this? I don't think so. I think a lot of people is just finna, you know, get jiggy with it if the authorities don't step in and start doing something. And I'm hoping and I'm praying that they do step in before innocent people start getting hurt, because everybody ain't gonna put up with this mess. And like I told y'all before, a lot of people in Dallas, Texas right now is saying F around and find out. They're not gonna put up with the mess that's coming over here right now. They're not. A lot of places is not going to put up with this mess. So stay tuned, y'all. Stay tuned. Anyway, y'all, please like, share, and subscribe if you like this video. And thanks for watching, y'all. Peace.